Good evening, everyone, and welcome to your favorite Hearts exclusive channel, exclusively for NEET 2021 batch. So we are coming with the next lecture on the topic plan, growth and development. So here we have started the topic of phytohormones, or plant growth regulators, in our previous class, right? And today we have already completed the concept of auxins, and today we'll be continuing our super cool, super awesome and absolutely amazing class with the next phytohormone, that is gibberellin. Okay, if you are ready, let's recapitulate or recap what we have learned in our last class. And let's move with this today's wonderful class. Ready? So let's go. In the last class, we studied about the, started from this slide, right? Plant growth regulators. We have seen about two type of regulators are there. That is a plant growth promoters and plant growth inhibitors. Plant growth promoters means it promote the activity of growth, flowering, fruiting, seed formation, etc. For example, auxin, gibberellin, cytokinin. Then plant growth inhibitors are those which what decreases the growth or inhibit the growth and promotes activities such as dormancy and abscission. For example, abscisic acid and ethylene. So we have studied that about the auxin. Auxin means to grow in the Greek language. And the auxin hormone was discovered by Charles Darwin and his son, Francis Darwin, from the coleoptile of a canary grass, which was an example also for a phototropism. F.W. went for the next scientist who isolated auxin from the tips of coleoptile of oat seedlings. And remember that auxin was not first isolated from the plants, it was isolated from human urine. There were two types of auxins, that is natural auxins and artificial or synthetic auxin. Examples of natural auxins that are derived or isolated from plants. Example is indole 3 acetic acid, IAA, IBA or indole butyric acid. Synthetic NAA, naphthalene acetic acid, and 2,4-D-2,4-dichlorophenoxyacetic acid. Okay, auxin we have learned. So we have learned about the functions of auxin, also promotes rooting in stem cuts, promote flowering in pineapple. You may ask a question, name the phytohormone responsible for flowering of pineapples. The answer is auxin. Then prevent fruit and early drop or abscission of older leaves. Induces parthenocarpy in tomatoes. Herbicides 2,4-D-2,4-dinitrophenoxyacetic acid. Okay, so in today's class, we will be studying about gibberellin. Okay, we'll be studying about gibberellin. Is it clear? Okay, what are gibberellin? So our next hormone that we are going to study today is gibberellins. Okay, is it clear? Gibberellins are acidic plant growth regulator. Gibberellins are acidic plant growth regulator. E. Kurosawa was a scientist. Okay, he treated the sterile filtrates of Gibberella fugicoroi. Okay, which was a fungus that causes foolish seedling disease in rice. Okay, if you have seen the post period of rice cultivation, you will see that most of the rice contains endosperm inside, whereas some other rice doesn't contain anything inside it. That is foolish seedling in rice. Okay, or Bakenay disease. Foolish seedling in rice. Or Bakenay disease. Okay, to healthy rice plants. As a result, it showed the symptoms of Bakenay disease. Later, the substances were identified as gibberellic acid. Okay, name the phytohormone that causes Bakenay disease or foolish rice disease. It is gibberellic acid. There are more than 100 gibberellic acid known. Okay, more than 100 gibberellic acid in fungi and higher plants. For example, GA1, GA2, GA3, etc. 100 gibberellic acids or gibberellins are there. Neat MCQ, very, very important. This foolish rice disease is 10 times a repeated your question. 10 times neat MCQ. Okay. Gibberellic acid or GA3, terpene. Another name for GA3 or gibberellic acid number 3 is terpene. Is one of the first discovered. Name the first discovered gibberellic acid, GA3 or terpene, and is studied intensively, used for studying the gibberellin. So from this you have to study nothing but you have to remember this some points such as gibberellins are acidic plant growth regulators. E. Kurosawa treated the sterile filtrates of gibberella. Gibberella fugicoroi, that is a fungus that causes bacony disease or foolish seedling in rice. Very, very important. And these substances were identified as gibberellic acid. More than 100 gibberellins are identified in fungi and plants, and gibberellic acid number 3 or terpenes are the first discovered. Are the first discovered and the most intensively studied gibberellin. Is it clear? Yes. Next, without wasting much of our time, we are moving on to gibberellin functions. Okay, functions of gibberellin or gibberellic acid. They are used to increase the length of the axis. They are used to increase the length of the axis. Okay, gibberellins are used to increase the length of the axis. So they are used to increase the length of grape stalks. Okay, gibberellins are used for increasing the grape stalk. Okay, to elongate and to improve the shape of fruits such as apple. Okay, in order to change and convert the shape of apple, we use what? Gibberellic acid. And for increasing the length of the grapes, we use gibberellic acid. They delay senescence. Very important. Neat MCQ previous year. Name the phytohormone that delays senescence. It is gibberellin. GA3 is used up to speed up the process of malting process in brewing industry. Okay, malting process in brewing industry. That's always gibberellin's function. Okay, one second. Yes. Fifth function is sugarcane stores sugar in stem. Spraying sugarcane crop with gibberellin increases the length of the stem. So length of the plant, length of the stem or length of the axis in grape, length of the stem in sugarcane is all the function. Increase in the length is a function of gibberellins. Okay. Spraying juvenile conifers with gibberellic acid hastens the maturity period. It leads to early seed production. It is also used for the process of bolting. That is internal elongation just prior to flowering in beet, cabbage, and many plants with rosette habitat. That is rose habitat. Okay. So all these are the different functions of gibberellins. Is it clear, everyone? So what are the main functions of gibberellin? They are used to increase the length of the axis in grapes, elongate and improve the shape of the fruit such as apple, delay senescence, and using the malting process in brewing industry. They are used in bolting process, increasing the internodal elongation in beet, cabbages, and rosette habitat plants. Then early seed production hastens maturity period and also the length of the stem. Next, our hormone is cytokinin. Okay, cytokinin. Okay, next our hormone is cytokinin. F. Shug and his co-workers observed the internodal segments of tobacco. Internodal segments of tobacco stems, the callus, a mass of undifferentiated cell. Neat MCQ. What is meant by callus? Callus is a mass of undifferentiated cells. And F. Shug. This also 100% neat MCQ. F. Shug and co-workers observed the internodal increase in the length of tobacco called the callus. Proliferated only if the nutrient medium was supplemented with vascular tissues, coconut milk or DNA. Shug and Miller later identified and crystallized the active substance and termed it as kinetin. Cytokinins were discovered as kinetin. Cytokinin or cytokinin was discovered as kinetin, which was an adenine derivative, okay, from an autoclaved herring sperm DNA. From the autoclaved sperm DNA, the cytokinin was identified as what? Kinin. Okay. Kinin. Kinetin, okay, not kinin, it's kinetin. It does not occur naturally in a plant. Very important. So cytokinin or kinetin does not occur directly or naturally in a plant. Okay, so next, Seattin. What is Seattin? From the corn kernels or coconut milk. We are obtaining Seattin from corn kernels or coconut milk. Or coconut milk is a natural substance with cytokine-like activities. Okay, there are some synthetic compounds with cell division promoting activity. Natural cytokinins are synthesized in the region of rapid cell division. In the regions of rapid cell division, such as root apex, shoot buds, and young fruits. Okay. Functions of cytokinin, they play a role in cytokinesis or cell division. Division of cytoplasm, this is a cell, a plant cell. Drawing. I'll draw a plant cell itself. Okay, I'll draw a plant cell. And the cytokinin play an important role. In the plant, there is a cell plate formation, right? In plants, cytokinesis is by formation of a cell plate, right? Actually, my pen is not going as how I am writing. That's why the problem. It helps to produce a new leaf. It helps to produce a new leaf. In chloroplast in leaves, lateral shoot growth and adventitious shoot formation. Okay, adventitious shoot formation helps to overcome apical dominance. Very important. Helps to overcome apical dominance and they promote nutrient mobilization. They promote nutrient mobilization and delay the leaf senescence and delay the leaf senescence. Okay. So, next is ethylene. From ethylene onwards, we'll be discussing in our next class. Okay. Thank you all for your patient listening and wonderful session will be coming and uploading by us. So please don't forget to like, share and subscribe our wonderful channel. We will help you to crack NEET. Okay. Please do share it with your friends and support our channel. Thank you all.